I got involved with aerial skiing at the age of 17. I was a gymnast for about 10 years and then I stopped gymnastics and I had to retire. I had a few injuries and that's when the Olympic Wind Institute gave me a call and asked if I'd like to transfer my skills to aerial skiing. Landing my second jump in the Olympic final, you know, we only get two jumps every 4 years to prove that we're worthy of an Olympic medal. So landing that second jump was just an amazing sense of relief at first and satisfaction knowing that all the hard work I'd put into landing and competing and performing those tricks had really paid off at that one final moment. So it's an amazing feeling and one I relive every day, and you know, hopefully I'll get to relive another one of those moments.
Gold medalist and Olympic champion representing Australia, Lydia Lassila.
I think the type of person that makes a really good aerial skier is one that's self-driven, because there is a lot of time spent on the road, you know, travelling to different countries all around the globe, and you have to be self-driven, you have to be independent, you have to be self-motivated in order to cope with the lifestyle and progress every day and achieve your goals. I think coming from a sport where I was in gymnastics, you know, and everything was a very controlled environment, I got told what I needed to do every day, I had a program set for me. Going into aerial skiing, I found that a lot of the decisions were really up to me. And if I wanted to be the best in the world, that was going to have to be driven from me. So I think to even begin the sport, you have to be self-driven, motivated, determined, and be willing to really try and get the best out of yourself. Aerial skiing has been a wonderful sport for me. It's given me so much. You know, it's given me life experiences that I'll never forget. I've been to so many countries around the globe and experienced so many different cultures and met so many different people and have so many friends. Like, my competitors are my friends as well, and that changes a bit on competition day, but you know, we are friends and we will be for a long time. So I think it enables you to develop an international network that you can draw on in the future, leading into other roles that you might take. So it's given me a lot. It's given me the chance and the opportunity to go to 3 Olympic Games so far, and now on my way to my 4th. So that's something that I've always wanted from, you know, I was a 6-year-old when I first realised that I wanted to go to an Olympic Games, and aerial skiing's given me that opportunity to experience the Winter Olympics. My advice to anyone trying to get involved in aerial skiing is to really know what you want to achieve. You know, you have to know about the sport, you have to, you know, obviously research it and know who the competitors are and what it takes to be able to achieve at the top level, because it's not an easy sport. I think we do a good job at making it look easy, but the preparation has to be there. You have to follow the steps, and that's including in your diet. You need to be strong and healthy in the gym. You need to train your mind to be able to cope with pressure or fight back from injuries or compete well. So, you know, there's so many elements to being a successful athlete. You have to be able to have balance in your life away from sport as well. I think that's really important, you know, and whether it's studying or starting a business or having a different job or another outlet away from sport, I think helps you balance your whole life. The Victorian Institute of Sport have always been there for me. You know, it's an amazing support network, whether you're needing, you know, services like massage or physiotherapy or psychology or sports science or biomechanics, or different areas like your career advice and schooling advice. You know, it's always been there for me, and particularly when times have been difficult for me, for instance, when I've had injuries, the VIS were there to help me rehabilitate and get back to where I needed to be. You know, there's so many services here that we can draw on, and if you use them, then they're just going to help you and add as that other stepping stone to achieving the maximum out of yourself. So if you do have an interest in, you know, participating in aerial skiing or interested in the sport, the VIS is a great starting point, and to, you know, obviously express your interest, and then they'll be able to see if you're going to be able to fit the bill.